Yes.
Welcome to my world.
Honey, Doughboy said where the thick women at. I was in the back wheezing. Now I'm up here, so I caught my breath. Oh, but yeah, women, comedian, it's great. I'm actually going to be very anti-feminist and talk about a big old slut. Does anyone else love their mother?
Yes.
I love my mother. I'm going to that. My mom and I are best friends. I actually did a lot of sets about her. When I first started, but then I kind of stopped because I was like, the mom stuff. Sometimes it gets boring, especially when you have like a good relationship with your mom. Because like, if you don't have mommy issues, why are you up here, I guess? But no, we're good. But after I stopped doing sense about her, she was kind of like, oh, like when are you gonna talk about me again? I guess right now, fucking attention whore. Like, what's that? But we are besties, we're best friends. We're very similar. Probably too much, but we differ a little, a few ways. Like, we're both outgoing. Like, I'm outgoing enough to, like, do shit like this, but she's, like, outgoing enough that, like, if we were, like, being robbed at a bank, like, by the end of it, like, she would, like, be, like, comforting the robber. Like, he'd be, like, dumping all of his darkest secrets. But I'd be in the corner, like, with a target, like, please just fucking shoot me. Like, but also like social and friendly level, like at parties she'll say hi to everybody. I am still trying to perfect the Irish goodbye. You know, like my goal is to Irish goodbye. My goal at parties is for you not to know that I was there. So I'm still working on that. I will say our biggest difference, and I don't know if a lot of people compare this with their mother, is that she's a lot more sexual than me. Don't know if anyone's having this conversation with their mother. Unfortunately, I hear them quite often. Mostly because I'm like, our difference is I'm basically the borderline asexual and she's fucking everybody in Orlando. Our taste in men is also a little different too. Currently, she's fixated on bald, chubby men. So some of you guys got a shot tonight. But my taste in men is women. Woo! Diversity hire, right? So she got divorced from my dad when I was an adult, so I don't really have any trauma from that, so that's why I'm not really funny. But I did see my mom go through a hoe phase, which is kind of a weird thing, because I basically was the mother in most of these situations. You know, she lives in Orlando, so I'm like, girl, I'm not worried about you getting pregnant because you don't have a uterus, but the STDs down there are crazy, so please be careful. I say that she's fucked all types of cultures since living in Orlando, but I really mean that she's just fucked a shit ton of Epcot employees. You call her a Disney. You can call her a Disney adult, because she is, but I also call her a Disney adultress. Because she will fuck anyone as long as she gets free tickets to that fucking park. And I support it because I also want to go to Disney. But so back to me being borderline asexual. Maybe because sex parties, I don't always get sex. Like, to me, sex and math are the same thing. They never add up really to me. Watch that. I'm sorry. But okay, so I have had sex. I'd like to practice this. I'm not a virgin. But I lost my virginity, and it was kind of like, you know, I feel like people try to make that a special moment, but me, I was like, I just got enough. Like, people wait till marriage for this shit. Like, is it worth it? So I lost my virginity in a very romantic way at a frat function in college in the most romantic city, St. Louis, Missouri. And I kept saying, I just want to have sex. Like, what's the hypothesis on sex for me is X plus Y equals me come. Right? That night, X did not equal Y. Did not come. And so that's why I'm like, this sex, I think the moral of this whole set is that I've had bad sex. And so is asexuality really that you don't want to have sex, or is that you just never found anyone who was good enough? And I may have just solved sexuality.